Hi, we're the Sugar Babes.
And you're watching Our Life in Music.
You're going to get to know us quite a bit better over the next hour. We're going to be talking about songs that we wish we'd written.
Songs that we love to do at karaoke.
Yeah, and the tunes that make your stomach flutter, and ones that remind you of like loved ones and good times back in the day.
But first of all, we are going to start off with the song that was number one when each of us were born. What was the song that was number one when you was born?
Me, it was Hello by Lionel Richie.
Hello.
That's a really good one to have.
Do you remember the video for that?
Yeah, I do.
I couldn't get over
Is that the one with the head?
I couldn't get over that. There's like this long intro and then he answers the phone, she answers the phone, and the intro is like 16 bars and then he goes, hello. And then, like, in real words, someone would have been like, hello. I remember that ages ago. The song that went to number one when I was born was by Stevie Wonder, and it was I Just Call to Say I Love You.
You've got really good ones. I'm sure it's a good song, but I don't really know mine. It's Candy Girl. By a new edition.
I love that song. I remember in the beginning of Sugar Babes, we did a rendition of it, a cover of it. Candy girl, you are my world. And I think we kind of did Sugar Boy.
I know what you're talking about now.
Okay, well, first of all, we are going to show you the video that was number one when Keisha was born. And this is
Stevie Wonder.
I just called to say, I love you.
Okay, that was Stevie Wonder, number one when I was born.
Yeah, I really like that one, actually.
Yeah. And what posters do you girls have on your wall when you were younger?
I used to have posters of Madonna, because I was a huge fan of Madonna. But I had New Kids on the Block.
I had Bob Marley actually.
Actually, I made it my mission when I was younger to cover my bedroom full of posters. So all the ceilings were covered, the walls, the door from the inside and
That's
out.
That's hardcore, Keith.
One of my first ever posters was Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
Because obviously I was a diehard, hard fan of his. But going back to Bob Marley, that's the next video, isn't it?
Yeah, it is actually. Could You Be Loved?
Right, next up, we are going to be showing our face crush songs. And I think for me, the song that reminds me of face crush, apart from the Grease medley that they used to play at the school disco at the end, and it would finish with the slow song.
Yeah, the one
you'd be looking to like dance slow with the boy you fancied at school. The next one to that was Aerosmith, Don't Want to Miss a Thing.
Oh, I love that
and
song.
And I was dating some lad at school. I think I must have been about 14, something. And I remember we went to town shopping together after school, and he bought me this CD in Virgin Megastores.
Oh, bless
him. I used to play it all the time.
And what was yours?
Can't really remember, tell the truth.
Did you have one?
I remember there was a song from Usher's album, I think it was called Slow Jams or something.
Right.
Play another slow. Me and my boyfriend was actually singing that to each other in the car the other day.
He's got a really good voice.
So I was like, ah, and he was like, ah. I was thinking, and when we finished, we were like, that was so corny. But anyway.
And now you've shared it with everybody. But anyway, here is Aerosmith with Don't Want to Miss a Thing.
Just have a quick break, so don't you go anywhere.
And we'll be back in a few minutes to show you some more videos.
Hi, we're the Sugar Babes, and welcome back to Our Life in Music. We're basically going through songs that have had a big impact on our lives, songs that we love to karaoke to, and songs
first
that basically...
First crush songs.
First crush songs,
yeah.
All that good stuff. But now let's talk about our first gig. So I know that my one was a band called Jodeci.
Ah.
And I remember my dad taking me to Wembley Arena, and back then there was this like really cool R&B group, and I just loved them. And I remember Mary J. Blige, just when she first came out with her album.
No, you didn't see her.
Yeah, so she was on stage. I think she was dating one of the members, and he came on Royal Roses and stuff during her set because she supported them. And that was really good.
Wow. My first gig was Toni Braxton in Manchester. And she was amazing. She really was. It was like during the whole Unbreak My Heart time. She was fantastic.
My very first proper live concert thing was probably Pink.
That's a good one.
Yeah, it was absolutely amazing. I remember hanging from the ceiling, and like doing like those acrobat things with the big
She's
stretchy
really
thing.
Good.
She's literally like a ballerina, honestly. It was amazing.
We supported her. In Australia one.
Just to say the word, but yeah, I'm jealous.
we like for two nights, was it?
Oh, yeah.
Was she on?
She's
lovely.
And that's the video we've chosen now, right?
Yeah, it is.
It's Pink and Family Portrait.
Hey, ladies, what was your first record you ever bought?
Oh. My first record was The Immaculate Collection by Madonna. I still listen to it. It was on cassette.
You leave it in your car, don't you?
Well, it was on cassette, and about a few years ago, I had to go and get it on CD from my car.
I loved Michael Jackson. The first album was the Bad album.
Bad, yeah.
And I loved the song Liberian Girl on it because I was, like, obsessed that that was about me being in the Libra.
No.
And until one of you guys said, actually, it's a country. Well, yeah. Okay, cool. So, yeah.
Okay, here is one of the songs from the Immaculate Collection, and I'm going to choose Lucky Star. So this is Lucky Star by Madonna. What is the one video that you would have liked to have been in?
I would have liked to have been in Michael Jackson's The Way You Make Me Feel, just because, and we were actually talking about it the other day, because we were saying Mel's hair reminds us of, like, the girl in the video, but I just always wanted to wear that dress.
Oh, the black one,
what
tight
dress
one.
Did they wear?
It's a really small, right? Black, tight one.
It's kind of like what we're wearing on tour at the moment. You know, the thing that it's basically a really tight
fitting
dress.
Did it have tassels all over it?
No, it was just plain black, and Michael Jackson was in this cool shirt, but I just really liked the whole thing, and I've always wanted to wear a dress like that, and we're kind of doing that on this
because
tour anyway.
When I was younger, I was in a kid's road show. We used to go around doing gigs in, like, social clubs and pubs. Aww. And stuff, and it was like a kids' cabaret show, and there was a boy called Thomas. He must have been about 12 at the time, and we were all about 10, and we used to wear these little white satin dresses with white tassels all over, and we were his backing dancers for The Way You Make Me Feel. But you felt really, like, really grown up, like 10, in your little tassel dress. It was brilliant. So, yeah, I do like that song.
And what video would you like to?
I would have liked to have been in... Well, I don't know. I actually can't
Candy
think.
Candy Shop 57. I'm joking.
I think I'd like to have been
in... Bouncing
in November Rain. I love that video.
Yeah,
just one of the guests at the wedding.
Yeah. You know? Oh, that would have been a good one.
Yeah.
Or just be the actual girl. Running.
Well, I haven't got any legs. And legs are up to me.
Well, you're hot stuff too, so I don't want to hear I'm going. Anyway, let's have a look at a video.
Okay, here is Michael Jackson, The Way You Make Me Feel.
Now, I think we'd all agree that we actually all love Alicia Keys.
Yeah,
she's amazing.
Amazing.
And that was, like, the last record that you guys
bought,
right?
That was the last album that both of us
me
bought.
Me and you, yeah.
All the songs are brilliant on the album, but this is No One by Alicia Keys.
That was Alicia Keys, and we absolutely love that song, don't we?
Yeah.
We're going to go away for a few minutes, but we will be back with our life in music.
Yep, and when we do get back, we're going to be showing you all the songs that remind us of our boyfriends.
Welcome back. We're the Sugar Babes. I'm Heidi.
I'm Keisha.
And I'm Amel.
We're going to tell you about the songs that remind us of being a teenager. One song that I associate with that was Ice Baby.
Oh, yeah.
They always used to play it at my school disco.
Always.
And the boys always took it upon themselves to try and show off. No, they used to go on the floor and do that.
Oh,
you
know,
where you swap hands.
Yes, I do remember that.
That's when the Running Man first came out, actually. I remember doing it. And it was all about doing it with your legs forward. But then you got some people who were doing it backwards.
Oh, yeah.
Literally travelling this way.
Right.
So it's like the moonwalk, basically.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, here it is.
Okay, right, now we're going to be talking about our boyfriends and what songs remind us of them.
Yes.
I haven't got one particular song.
See, I've got one, but I can't remember how the tune goes. It's a dance tune. And it just always reminds me when me and my baby would start going out with each other.
Oh, I know. Yours is... baby, you're all that I want. Yours is that, isn't it? Yeah.
Because I remember us then, we got back one night from dinner, and that just it was just playing once, and we're like, oh, it's a lovely song, and yeah.
Mine, I think
any
Frank Sinatra songs remind me of Dave.
Yeah, oh
just
yeah,
because
I can
see
that.
We love Frank Sinatra, and it reminds me of our first holiday in New York, because we were going to New York. We both bought each other Frank Sinatra albums, because it had New York, New York on. We both had the same idea and gave them to each other as one of our Christmas gifts.
I think Dean's one's basically going the complete opposite for you. He loves Tupac, and he loves anything by him, and I do as well, and he's got so many different songs that he likes, but the one that I've chosen, which we can actually show, is California Love, and I think this is an amazing song, and hope you enjoy it.
Welcome back, we're the Sugar Babes, and and you're watching our Life in Music. Right now, we want to show you our new single, which is Denial. Mm-hmm. And this is probably one of our favourite videos that we've...
Well, one of my favourite videos that
we've done. We had so much fun shooting it, trying on so many, many different outfits.
Yeah. The director was amazing to work with. His name's Harvey.
Yeah.
And he's
actually
helping us with our new tour as well. Yeah.
He's just amazing. He's just so quirky and just so out there. And he's like, oh,
mad ideas.
And he was chucked something at you. It's just, I love the way he works.
The songs on ours basically just about, I think someone just... being in denial that they've fallen in love with this person, they totally didn't want it to happen, but it just kind of happened, and they can't believe it, all that kind of stuff. So,
or yeah, that you couldn't, like maybe it's a good friend or something, it's something that you can't, you know what, I'm going way too deep into it. So,
you know, but they get the point, don't they?
Yes, and you can figure it out yourself. Okay, that was Denial, and we hope that you enjoyed it. We've come to the end of the show now, but thank you for watching.
Hope you've enjoyed it.
Yes, and see you later.